The following clip is a conversation about body armor and helmet hits between Jocko Willink and Leif Babin, a pair of Navy SEALs. At one point, Leif shares this interesting story on Jocko's podcast.
One of our guys peeking up over the rooftop during a big gunfight, bam, takes all of a sudden he felt like somebody punched him in the face and kind of falls back down below the roof and kind of gets up wondering what's happening and takes off his helmet, looks at his helmet, realizes he's been shot in his night vision mount, which meant that round came in directly, you know, at his face, hit his night vision mount and ricocheted up. Had it hit just, you know, millimeters lower, it would have taken his head off.
There are tons of internet articles about helmet hits stopping rounds, but universally, the rounds they stop either would have missed the head of the wearer already, or appear to have hit where a night vision mount was placed, just like Leif's buddy. Take, for instance, the helmet of the SWAT officer shot during the Orlando nightclub shooting that tanked a direct hit where his mount was. I'm obligated to try this out, so I've got a bunch of these Marine Corps lightweight helmets that were donated by a fantastic friend of mine. I miss you, man. You're awesome. And these are fairly similar to early generation Army Advanced Combat helmets and offer excellent protection. I've also got a set of commonly used American night vision mounts, including Noritos mounts, a pair of Rhinos, and a three-hole aluminum Noritos mount that I've seen a lot of SEALs from Jocko's generation using. The offender will be a suppressed Yugoslavian M64 rifle. It's a 7.62x39 AK with a normal AKM length barrel. Bit of a hipster gun, but, you know, it's special. I like it. It's mine. It's my milled beauty. Anyway, for ammunition, I've got red, which represents standard supersonic lead core ammunition, yellow, Norinco mild steel core ammunition, representing a potential conventional military threat, and green, which is brown bear lead core subsonic ammunition, representing a longer distance impact at around 450 meters. Each hit will be taken at no less than 10 feet with a straight angle every time. I'll be changing up the mount configurations after each shot. Keep in mind, an angled shot to a night vision mount or a helmet would absolutely make a difference though. I'm just doing this for consistency. Even though this helmet has decent protection, it will still fail to subsonic ammo. This control round cleanly passed through both sides of the helmet, so let's try to see if the Potmel Noritos makes a difference. But before we get to that, a word from my sponsor, Crossout. Crossout is a free-to-play multiplayer Mad Max-style vehicle shooter where you create your own unique vehicles from scratch and then take them out on either PvP or PvE matches. The PvE itself is pretty expansive and actually has a proper campaign. And there's a ridiculous number of parts, armor plating, propulsion methods, and weapons from lasers, rockets, and guns. All of which can be blasted off your vehicle thanks to the detailed damage model. That damage model makes it particularly important when making your own vehicle in the in-game editor. Think deep about your design, then test it out, or just go right into battle. I personally got my kicks from the friggin' coaxial rotor you can slap on your vehicle. There isn't a lack of players to fight either, considering that the game is cross-platform and runs on PC, Xbox One, Xbox Series X and F, or PlayStation 4 and 5. New or current players can use my link in the description to get a free bonus, including 3 days of premium time and unique cosmetics. New players using the code will get the Adventure Seeker vehicle. Coaxial rotor. Oh man. Alright, back to work. The first shot is at the pot metal Noritos mount versus the subsonic 7.62x39 ammo. The mount is absolutely shattered, but the helmet has now stopped the round of minor deformation. This subsonic bullet would have penetrated through and through otherwise though, so it's already proof that the metal makes a difference and is a pretty interesting result to start with. Also, I'm pretty sure that our supersonic ammo would have gone right through the flat mount, judging by the residual deformation on the helmet, so for the next shot, let's add the Rhino mount. Leif Babin wasn't kidding. From what is basically a point-blank range shot, you can stop what is a full-power AK round if you happen to be extremely lucky. There isn't even any deformation to speak of, and this spot was very near to the screw mounting hole, a point of the helmet that's supposed to be weaker. Let's try a mild steel core ammo. To my understanding, most conventional armies using 7.62 make use of steel cores in their rounds, though I can't speak for what's been exported out into the world. A lot of plain core lead ammo is also used by militaries. Still, a humble, mild steel core can make a world of difference ballistically. In this case, the round penetrated the arm, mount, and helmet. I'm not sure what difference the round would need to be shot at to be stopped by this arrangement, and I don't have the money or time to ball out enough surplus to figure out the exact distance on when it will penetrate and when it won't. If I do get a chance to try again, I'd try with a subsonic loaded steel core, and that would give me a better idea. But right now, I'd rather test another type of mount, the aluminum three-hole Noritos. Let's hit it with a subsonic round to see if it fares better than the pot metal Noritos mount. Not only is the deformation less on the inside of the helmet, but the mount is intact and fully usable still. I think I'll keep rocking this one. Thanks again to Crossout for sponsoring this video. Use my link in the description to try Crossout and get that free bonus. I personally think it's worth it just to mess around with the new helicopter trucks. So this really closes the case on all the talk about helmets occasionally stopping bullets. The conclusions I've reached between all the helmet test videos generally reinforce common sense. Your Kevlar won't stop rifle bullets unless they hit something else mounted on your helmet first, or they would have missed your head anyway and are glancing or crown hits. This was a fun video to make, and if you're serving and hear another night vision mount story from some old salty dude from the Surge like I've been hearing, don't doubt him. It's very possible. Weirder stuff has happened. And for God's sakes, remember what Jocko said at the end of this clip.
Some of the army guys they would have the full, they look like almost like knights.
The crotch protector.
Yeah, the crotch protector, yeah. The collars, the arm sleeves, the side sappy plates, they were covered up good on them because they were taking real risks out there. So yeah, but Jody Middick and I, when he was on here, we had a little conversation about body armor. They didn't op and expected to be in a certain spot. They weren't there. They didn't have body armor helmets on. And he's sitting here saying, I wish I would have had them. So wear your body armor, wear your helmet all the time.